Welcome to Space Quest 5, I'm your host lostwolfe. This is episode 6, and so we have Cliffy over here. We went down to the planet, we got shot of our friend WD-40, and now we're going to go do something else entirely. So before I sit down and we do this, one thing I ought to mention, no, actually maybe I'll mention it when we get closer to it. We will just do what we need to do for now. Have a seat. And let's talk to our friends. Sorry, Flo, never mind. What do you know about our destination, Flo? Well, I kind of forgot where we were supposed to be going, Flo. We've finished our mission, Captain. Let's take some R&R at the space bar. We don't have a destination, so, which is true, we don't. How does the refuse recovery system work at all? When we finish our mission, where's a good place to go for shore leave? How did you come to be posted to Dereka? Never mind. Pardon you, Captain. Okay, let's start with that. Refuse Recovery System, or RRS for short, is the primary means by which the Hooper-class garbage scouts perform their designated mission. Oh, sorry. The underlying system is relatively simple. A vacuumatic containment field works in conjunction with tractor beams to suck up debris and space trash. After collection, refuse is moved into the UK's quantum garbage compactor, where it can be reduced for transport to a designated dumping zone. Wow, and I thought the floor scrubber in Arcata was impressive, in the Academy was impressive. When we finish our mission, where's a good place to go for some shore leave? There aren't a lot of options open to us, Captain. The only place that's even halfway decent in this sector is the space bar. Maybe we'll have to check it out. I certainly hope we will, sir. How did you come to be posted on Dereka? It's kind of a long story. Relax, there's plenty of time until the travel timer runs out. I was involved in a very unfortunate accident, sir. It was while I was serving on the SAS Stupendous. That's a great name for a ship. It was a mistake anyone could have made, really. I'm listening. We were patrolling in the neutral zone when an unidentified ship suddenly popped up on our screen. So naturally, I opened fire with everything we had. That sounds good. Naturally. She was blown to bits instantly. Unfortunately, it turned out to be one of our own robotic freighters. Imagine your embarrassment. Yeah, anyhow, after that, I got canned and transferred to Eureka. What did you do, sir? You must have screwed up pretty bad to get stuck with a command like this. Well, stick somebody who'll feel good. I don't know. Well, come to think of it, probably the latter. Okay. Yeah, there isn't anything else here. I don't think Flo is going to give us. Okay, so we could issue a command. We want to land a course. Captain, we've been on duty for quite a while now, sir, and I think we could all stand some R&R. Okay. We are going to go to the space bar. Coordinates locked in, sir. Ready to get underway. Okay, let's go to standard. Let's go regular speed. The ship is already at regular speed, Captain. Pinhead. Oh, sorry. What I wanted to do was go light speed. Aye, sir. Okay, let's talk to Flo now. What do you know about a destination, Flo? The spacebar is a great place to hang out, Captain. Let's think. That's about it. Oh, I kind of forgot where we're supposed to be going, Flo. Oh, okay. I was hoping she'd say something different. Okay, never mind. So while we're traveling, I should bring this up real quickly. We're approaching our destination, Captain. What we're about to see, and I'm gonna go regular speed. Hi, sir. Is very much if you have played, if you've watched Star Trek at all, what we're about to witness is something akin to The Troubles, which is an episode of Star Trek from the original series, season 2, episode 44. And if you've seen that at all, then you sort of have some idea of what's going to happen here. Oh, you know what? I should have did standard orbit. Oops. Yeah. Okay, we're there. Well, we should be there anyway. Standard orbit? Standard orbit. Ah, okay, there we go. Oh, goodness. That's better. Let's party. Last run down to the station is a rotten orbit ovum. Oh no, that's a throwback to the first game. Alright, was a dude on a planet. Corona. I'll get it right this time. And you used dehydrated water to kill him. Well, that was one way to kill him. I need to grab Spikey. Spikey, come here. You don't need to mess with WD-40 at this point. Just grab a spike and away you go. Oh, good grief. I thought he'd just walk there and issue the command. But evidently not. Excuse me, Captain, but I see an old buddy of mine over there by the bar. Uh-oh, here we go again. Okay, so we are all stationed over here, so let's go grab a seat. Not here. I guess I have to walk there. Hello, I am your cocktail waitress, Analog Bzzzt. What's your poison, humanoids? I'll have a double bourbon on rye. I'll have a fuzzy nostril. Give me a green goblin. Here are your drinks. The charges will be deducted from your StarCon account. If you feel the urge to hurl, please feel free to use the restroom, human. That's pretty cool. Hello there, partner. May I have a moment? Well, actually, I'm kinda... Allow me to introduce myself. Name's Nilo Jones, merchant of Venus. Dealer in fine collectibles, trafficker in rare artifacts. What's your moniker, son? I am, Roger Walker. Well, Walker, this is your lucky day. I could tell the first minute I set eyes on you that you're a discerning individual with an IQ significantly higher than the chair he was sitting in. A man who knows the value of fine merchandise when he sees it. Well, never fear, Walker. Nilo can fix you right up. Need some Antarian firewater? A few grey market copies of the latest Things Quest game? Or a lucky trouble spot? How about some Chernobyl cufflinks? They're a collector's item, you know. Guaranteed to give you that warm glow like only hard radiation can. Oh god, that's a terrible joke. I don't think... And this joke was, I can see you're looking for something special, Roger. Can I call you Roger? Well, I've got just a thing. Dehydrated space monkeys. They're all the rage in the colony walls. You don't have to feed them, and there's no mess for you, 15 buckers away. I'm not sure... You drive a hard bargain, Raj. I'll tell you what. You take a free sample of space monkeys and my business card with my compliments. Then, you buy something for your lady friend the next time you pass... through here. Thanks. Realizing is not going to make a big score here, the sales beast moves off to find another victim. He looks pretty human to me. There's nothing real beastly about him. Okay. Oh, another bit of the cutscene. This is a long cutscene, but there's things that happen that have to happen here. Well, 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 look who it isn't. Buzz off, laser brain. Enjoying your new command, trash man? I recommended you for the job. That's sanitation engineer to you, Crumb. Oh, an aristocrat. I bet Ambassador Wang must have been really impressed. She and I are having a great time working together closely on the Goliath. Quirk, you have the looks of an aurat and a manners to match. Why, you little? I can have you brought up on charges for that. I demand satisfaction. I challenge you to a game of battlecruiser, wimp. Fine, I'm gonna kick your aft side into the next quadrant, Quirk. Ha! We'll see about that, Boom Jockey. And off we go. That Chernobyl reference was new when this game came out, so it wasn't sort of an even worse joke to be making then. Play directions. Okay, let's save. I'm going to be doing an extra here, where I get 4 points for this, but right now, I'm just going to show you how Battlecruiser works. Let's do episode 6. Battlecruiser is exactly like battleships. If you played battleships, you'll understand Battlecruiser. You've got to sink the opposite man's battlecruiser, and you do that by guessing where his cruiser is. Let's play. Actually, you know what? Maybe I should get directions. because I haven't done this in a while. Everyone places their ships. You get four, he gets four, you put them down. Then, you take turns guessing positions. For example, B2 on board 1 might be a hit, but C3 on board 3 might be a miss. Whoever guesses most correctly wins. In other words, if you sink all the ships. When all four of either your ships or your opponent's ships are destroyed, the game will end. Okay, so, basically, I have this ship right here. If I hit next, it will take me to my next ship. And so on. I only have the four ships. So we've got sector 1, 2, and 3. This uses a very sort of Space Quest 3 looking thing. As long as I'm holding this particular ship, I can rotate it. And so on. So what you kind of want to do is you want to spread out your guys and sort of maybe put them where it's going to be a little bit difficult to find them. Let's do, this, and we'll put you, rotate you and put you like there. And let's go next. Let's rotate you. And next, I want to rotate, put you in sector 1. Now, one of the things it was saying was that, like, you can't put a ship on top of another ship. So this can't be on top of that one, for example. I want to find an empty sector. Let's do, like, and the other thing, I think. So there's a ship here, right in the bottom right-hand corner. If I go to sector 2, I can't now, let's go to sector 3. I can't now, I can. Okay, that covers both of those. That's alright then. Let's put this guy up over here. But kind of over there. Okay. I'm happy, we're going to hit done. This particular episode isn't going to run much longer. I just want to show you how it works. So, this we're seeing quirks out of the board now. We can pick a probe, or we can pick a weapon. We're going to pick a probe, and it's set a 5x5. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the best thing to do is to shoot it about here, in sector 1, and we're going to see what we're going to get. We get nothing, and we have one less probe. Okay, he didn't find anything. So the idea really is once you've got your board set up, you want to save scum, and you want to basically move around, find the ships, and kill them instantly. So let's do done. We shot over here, so I'm going to do, it would be 8 there, let's put a probe there, probe, there, aha, okay, so, like I said, we got a magenta ship, and, so now, since we're aware that there's a ship there, we can start firing our weapon and scoring hits. And And I'm going to shoot down his particular ship there. This looks to me like it's the if I go wait, let's just get as much as we can. Okay, so I don't believe that we've hit one of his ships completely down, because I think it would tell us. Well, let's have a look at what we have. We have... I want to say that what we've hit is something like that. So maybe the feet are over there. So, let's go and do done. Let's fire the weapon here. Aha. Weapon. And now, just from looking at this design over there, there is a head over there. So I'm going to go ahead and guess that the last three points in this here are over there. And weapon. I just want to show you what it looks like when you eventually sink a ship. There we go. Okay. So this will mark off his ship, and it will blow up. And that's basically Battlecruiser in a nutshell. Anyhow, that's the end of the weapon. Blast you, you nailed my large Battlecruiser. You weed. He's gonna hit mine. That's fine. He's gonna knock it out. Anyway, that has been Battlecruiser. I've been your host, lostwolfe. This has been Space Quest 5, Episode 6. When I see you next, the next thing that you're going to see is going to be an extra where essentially I battle cruiser and I win. I'm just going to basically save scum, note down where all the ships are, and then go and blow them up. Anyhow, I will see you all soon. Have a wonderful evening, and good night for now, folks. Thank you so much for watching.